Welcome, fellow knights, to my first online battle in Medieval Kingdoms Total War 1212 AD for Total War Attila. Now, please keep in mind that this is a work in progress. It's still closed alpha, so everything that you see in this video could potentially change. Also, this is the perfect time to voice your opinion if there's something that you think is broken, like a unit is too strong or too weak, or maybe there's something that you really enjoy in the mod and you want to see more of that. Write it down in the comment section. I'm sure the developers are going to be watching videos, looking at comments, and seeing how the community responds to their mod so far. So this is a 1v1 between me and Jackiefish. It's a little bit of a scenario battle. We have the Teutonic Order attacking the Grand Duchy of Lithuania. It's winter time. Winter is upon us. And look at this map. Is this not epic? This is great. You know, in literature, winter is always symbolic of death, and there's certainly going to be a lot of death in this battle. So let's get a quick zoom in on my Lithuanians over here. They look pretty awesome. Here's some of my spears. Here's some of my axemen, Ducal axemen. And then if we look over here, the Teutonic Order, they look stunning as well. They've got the white and black uniforms. They look really great. Nice detail in the helmets here. Very cool. So let's get started with the army comps. We will start with my awesome army first, of course, because they're Lithuanians. I'm always leading the pagans into battle. So on the front lines, my archers are the Ruthenian archers, and they're pretty good. They're tier 2. I don't have a lot of them. I'm kind of relying on their skill to win this battle against, you know, Jackiefish's lesser archers, because he is bringing some peasant archers. Let's get a nice close-up on these guys. And we're going to go pretty slow through the army comps so we can really see them in detail. So here they are. They look great. They look awesome. And then for my infantry, I have 2 units of noble swordsmen. They're pretty expensive, but it's worth the price. Oh yeah, and they got capes. I love me some capes. Good old style points for these guys. So they look pretty cool. And then for my more mid-tier infantry, I've got just standard axemen, who look pretty awesome as well. Not as noble, but, you know, they still have a lot of heart. They look cool. So like 3 units of them. And then in the back here, I've got 2 units of the Ducal axemen, which I believe is how you pronounce it. They're currently hiding a little bit, but they've got these big axes. They're like big men who just, you know, cut off other people's heads. They're ridiculous. And then I've got 2 units of the Baltic spearmen, which are very low tier, but, you know, they do pretty well. You'll see how well they perform in this battle. And then for my cav, I've got some armored cavalry. Check out the uniforms on these guys. They look so cool. So this is a melee cav. And through my experience, melee cav doesn't really perform that well in Total War Attila. I mean, at least, I could be wrong, but this is also what Jackiefish is telling me, and he's a little bit more experienced with Total War Attila. He just says, you know, bring the Lancer cav, because they're going to perform better overall in pretty much everything. But I've got a couple units, like 3 or 2 units of the armored cav, and then my Lancers over here, I've got 2 units of Boyars. And here's what they look like. Very cool. I've got one on this flank and then one on the other flank. And here's my general. It's the Lithuanian Grand Duke. Look at his crown. Look at the detail in the crown. Oh, and look how pissed he is. He's like, damn Teutonic Order in my lands. Alright, so that's my army. Let's look at the Teutonic Order. In the front lines were his archers. He's got 2 units of peasant archers, and we'll get a nice zoom in on them. You know, they just look like, you know, standard peasants, like Monty Python from the Holy Grail. I didn't vote for him. And then over here, we have 2 units of Prussian archers. So just like Medieval 2, they got the Prussian archers. They look a little bit better than the peasant archers. Tier 2, actually, too. So they're probably pretty equivalent to my archers. And then in the front lines for his infantry, he's got spear sergeants. We saw them earlier. And then he has about, let's see, 4 units of the Schwarzbruder, which I believe it translates to Brothers of the Sword. I'm just going to call them Sword Brothers just to be more convenient. But yeah, they look awesome. Just, I mean, the Teutonic Order, you cannot go wrong with the Teutonic Order. He's got some Teutonic Sergeants, and then here's his general over here, Grandmaster's Guard. What an awesome name. Oh my god, look at that helmet. Look at that. He is a champ. And then the rest of his cav, I believe he has all of Lancer cav. He's got like 4 units of Ritterbruder over here. Get a nice close-up on them. They look so good. Oh, look at this guy. Look at this guy. Oh, you can even see his eyes in there. That is awesome. So let us begin the battle, guys. And this one starts off pretty quick. Oh, general's giving out a speech.
Idiocy.
That actually, you know, kind of fits this battle, that speech. He's talking about how they're wrong and we're right. We'll fight for the pagan lords, the pagan gods. So yeah, I'm going to be pretty aggressive here. I'm moving up my archers. And I really don't know what to expect from this battle. Again, this is like one of my first battles. Oh, I love the sound effects of them running through the snow.
The enemy has been sighted.
And then I'm moving up my cav over here. I've got most of my cav concentrating on this flank.
Hidden troops.
And then I realized that he has more cav over on this flank. So this is a little concerning because I don't really have anything except one lancer cav. So I need to be really passive in this area. But on this side, I need to try to be aggressive. I need to try to commit my cav and start the battle. Oh, yeah, that's weird. The archers disappear when you zoom out. You see that? How they're gone? But if you zoom in, they are back. They're just using their invisible... you know, invisible perks. No, I'm just kidding. So I'm using fire arrows because I noticed that most of his army's in the trees here. So I'm just trying to, you know, set some fear. So I don't know if that really does anything. But it looks like I'm actually breaking some of his peasant archers back there, which is pretty funny. But look at that. His archers in the trees. It looks really cool. Oh my god. Here comes another volley coming in. So he definitely has the terrain over me. Oh, and the cav is about to engage. Let's see this. Actually, they've already engaged. So I'm pushing up my cav, my boyars, and some of my melee cav. I was going to go for his archers, but you know what? I felt like I should just surround his cav here. And then I'm pushing in my armored cav. I've got him surrounded, so that's a pretty good position for me so far. And then the other cav over here, I'm sending up the spears to support them. They're charging in, getting their spears wet. And he's going to disengage because he is a little bit afraid of the spears. But the problem of being so close to his army is that he can quickly push up his spear sergeants into the fight. And I'm trying to get my cav out of there because I don't want to engage those spears. And here comes his grandmaster cav. Grandmaster's guard. Trees are on fire. Archers are pushing up. The cav engagement has begun over here, but it's actually looking pretty good. I sent over my general, and some of my Ducal axemen are engaged in the melee. Look at that. They're chopping up the cav into pieces. Oh. Oh, get him off that horse. There we go. I'm running him down. So he's going to disengage there. And the archers are still having a little bit of a skirmish. It looks like my archers are doing very well. They didn't take any, like, many casualties. They're still firing. I'm actually focusing some of my archers into this big blob. Even though I'll get some friendly fire, I think it'll be worth it. Because there's a lot of them. His Teutonic spears trying to kill my Lithuanian cav. But I'm going to quickly get my spears into the action. Yeah, so some of my units here are breaking. Looks like my boyars are breaking from the fight. They just can't handle all those spears, which I don't blame them. And I'm trying to get... I assume I'm trying to get my spears around his cav. Let's see. Where am I running with these spears? This is not good micro. You're chasing down a unit that broke from the fight. Come on, Apollo. There we go. So I'm going to send him back. And then he's going to run his cav away. But there's still an epic struggle over here. Fighting for territory and their religious beliefs. Some cav returns to the battle. And I'm having a lot of success over on this side, though. But they are starting to harass my cav a little bit. They've got the trees on fire. I'm trying to run my cav out of there. Get him away. Get him out of range of his archers. My Ducal axemen resting. They're ready. I got some Baltic spears over here too. It looks so cool. I love watching units run through the trees. Oh, here comes a volley. So he pushed up his archers to try to harass my cav. They actually get some good hits right there. But I need to quickly get in the fight. The trees, man, I love when they catch on fire. And then he's going to countercharge me there, try to prevent, you know, me charging into his archers. But I do eventually reach the archers. But he has his spears nearby. Good, good micro, good teamwork using all his units to work together as one. Now my spears are surrounded, or my cav is surrounded by his spears and his cav. I'll give it a nice view of what's going on. And then I'm going to push up my infantry because I need to quickly send support. His archers are breaking, but my cav is getting slaughtered. The spears, man, they're too much.
Men are running. Stand and fight, damn you.
Stand and fight, damn you. Here comes my Baltic spearmen. They're now joining the battle. Oh, and the archers are just tearing up my army. Oh, the trees. I love seeing those trees on fire. It's so epic. So great. And then it looks like he's going for a cav charge, or like he's trying to circle around and surround my men. So he's got a free, you know, healthy Ritter Brooder here. His cav is starting to become a problem. Yeah, look at that flank. And now I'm pushing up my infantry. This big blob over here is still fighting. Still going on. The struggle between the cav and the spear units. So I'm going to go ahead and send up more support. I've got my axemen, Ducal axemen. They're about to charge in. A nice view of that. There they go. Oh, what are they stopping? There they go. Charge in there, boys. That is lovely. So that should definitely help me in this battle. Look at how they're like forming up around this blob. So they're kind of all surrounding them. And then let's go back to the infantry fight here, because the infantry has collided. My axemen are facing his sword brothers. Axemen doing pretty well. But he's got his Teutonic sergeants charging into my axemen. It's a great fight so far. This is a big concern right here. His cav is free to, you know, run around and get some hammer and anvil. He also has some spears flanking around. I'm trying to get as many kills with my archers, just trying to weaken their numbers and support my infantry, because I really don't want my infantry to get outflanked and just get slaughtered. Oh, here comes his cav. Oh, bless you, archers. Rip in pieces, archers. And there's nothing I can do about it. Oh, that was a beautiful charge into my archers. And this battle is not going in my way. My general is now under attack by his general. I'm quickly trying to get him out of there. Let's see, where is he? Where is he? Get out of there, general. Get out. There he is. There he is. He's still alive. I can see his shiny crown. Oh, is he doing a little duel? Is he doing a little dance? Oh, the archers, I think actually... Oh, and they killed him. He's dead. And my general... What? 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 What just happened? He's a magic man. Oh my god. Okay. I don't even know what to say. Like, that was interesting. So yeah, my general died-ish. I think he's leaving from the fight. He's breaking from the battle. But that was weird. So my infantry here is getting kind of surrounded, but the Lithuanian infantry, they don't mess around. Even though they're outflanked, they still fight on. And even though the general is dead, the morale is still strong. I mean, they love their people. They're going to keep fighting. Yes, they're not done yet. They're far from done. The sword brothers taking on my axemen. Oh, someone lost their head. So let's see what's going on over here. So there's just some cav action. So what I did is I actually peeled away one of my cav units that's fighting over there to contain the Ritter Brooder. But they are losing the fight. They're shaken and they're very tired. Combat is pretty even actually. And then I'm obviously winning on this flank, but I need to quickly send these guys over to the other side of the battle. You know, not having a general and getting outflanked over there is really costly. You're going to lose some battles if you lose your general like that. That's something I need to really work on. Sometimes I'm just so focused on like managing my archers or my cav. Sometimes I forget where my general is, and I know that's really bad. And I think in this battle, it really hurt me in the fight so far. But my axemen are tearing up these sword brothers.
Our men return to the fight.
And we are breaking his cav over here. But those Ritterbrüder, you gotta be careful. These are some deadly cav. It really was a pain to take care of them, to deal with them. But look at this, we're actually breaking some sword brothers. My noble swordsmen, they are nasty. I wish I got more of them because they're so good. They're outflanked, but it looks like some spears. But, you know, they just, you know, fighting back to back, protecting each other's flank.
From the enemy. This is shameful.
And then this unit over here, what is this? Some noble swords, not doing as well. They're having a tough fight against the Teutonic sergeants. Oh, and here comes a vicious cav charge. Oh, into my swords, and that's going to cause them to break. Who would want to keep fighting? Who would want to keep fighting? So my cav is free to run over here. I'm trying to just, you know, get some revenge, trying to run down his archers. He's charging in some spears. Try to stop my cav. Let's zoom out a little bit and see what's going on. I'm sending in my infantry, and it looks like another battle line is about to meet in battle. Form up the battle lines. This battle is far from over. Keep fighting. And now that I contained his infantry, I'm running down my cav. And running down his archers, is what I should say. Do not help the wounded. That's funny. And I got more cav over here. And the only thing I need to do, like, the only way I'm going to win this battle is to get some cycle charges. But then I notice something terrible. My axemen over here are breaking to spears. Why, axemen? Just keep fighting. We can win this. We can win this, men. So I'm going to try to support that flank with my cav. I'm going to send him over to the breaking axes against his spears. But here's my cav. My infantry is kicking butt. This is the axemen unit, and they're breaking more sword brethren. Brothers of the sword. But he's just got a lot of infantry, a lot more than I can fight. There they go, they're charging in. The Teutonic sergeants, they're pretty nasty. And I stopped chasing his archers because I really needed the support over here. Here comes more of my cav. Just forming up, and this is such a close battle. And I saw that he charged in his general. I'm going to try to kill him, but he just slips out, and I just can't catch up to him. And more breakage here from the spears, but oh, my army is breaking. Yes, it is against us. Oh, and the fire arrow is coming in. He's really trying to break my army. Got the trees on fire here. So epic looking. The Teutonic Order burning up my forest. And that's a very close defeat. It was a great fight, but really what it comes down to is not containing his cav and losing my general. So let's go ahead and end the replay and see how everyone did here. Okay, so here we are with the results. My army did pretty well. Some of my cav, my melee cav here actually got 307 kills, but I think a lot of those kills were archers, so I don't know the quality of those kills. My boyars did pretty bad. I mean, one got 64 kills, the other one only got 8. My axemen did pretty well. One got 137, the Ducal axemen. And then I got my noble swordsmen here. They both got around 100. My axemen did pretty decent for like mid infantry. And then my spears did okay too, getting 23 kills and 22 kills. And a lot of those kills were quality kills, you know, killing cav and killing his enemy spears. And my general only got 24 kills, so he didn't do that great. Looking at Jackie Fish's army, his general got 129 kills. One of his Teutonic sergeants, really good, got 100 and almost 70 kills. His peasant archers, not that bad for being peasants, 30 and 46. His Prussian archers, getting 16 kills and 71 kills. So one did pretty well. His cav did okay overall, except for that unit getting 16 kills. His infantry did pretty solid, and so did his spears. His spears actually did quite well, 80, 135, 58. So hopefully that gives you a good idea of what to expect from these two factions. I hope you enjoyed the video, guys. I will have more coming out soon. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Oh, and they killed him. He's dead, my general. What? 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 What?